Learn how you can use Microsoft Purview DevOps policies to set up centralized, scalable, and secure access to SQL. This week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. We're going to be talking about some exciting new stuff in the space of setting up secure and scalable access for SQL operations personnel. And in order to do this, I thought who better to bring on the show than some of our security experts and our governance experts, and that is Vlad and Serdan. So thanks so much for coming on Data Exposed. Now, before we kind of get into it, I'd like to understand, like, why would an organization that's using SQL kind of be interested in Microsoft Purview?
Yeah, let me provide an answer and then I'll let Serdan pitch in as well. Microsoft Purview is Microsoft's solution for mapping, understanding, governing, and ensuring that your data is compliant. And within Microsoft Purview, we have the Microsoft Purview data policies, which are about managing from a central place in the cloud. All your data access is compatible with the existing local access that you have set up for your data sources. So it offers path that is can let you use both at the same time until you kind of use policies from Purview more. And Serdan, do you want to address the question on
SQL? From the SQL side, there are a couple of kind of exciting scenarios why we would like to enable this. So we have this DevOps policies, kind of security monitor and a performance monitor also. So customers could basically with policies manage the access to their SQL at scale. So if they have, for example, a monitoring solution that they want to use to query their DMVs and get out kind of the stats of their performance of their data estate, they could, with a policy-based approach, they could do simply just kind of allow the performance monitor access to their monitoring solution. Or in case of SQL MI, that we would kind of demo a bit later, many customers kind of do MI's operational database like SQL DB. They tend to also use it for some kind of analytic workloads like data marts. And in that case, these self-service policies come very handy. They could orchestrate workflows through which data analysts could get access to SQL MI. This is kind of go through the business approval process and kind of finally they could generate some reports. And one thing that is very important here, because many of our customers that we've talked about ask for that, DBA stays in control. So these Purview policies access is kind of merged with what you have on the database. So deny always wins, and your database is secure and under your control.
Nice. Awesome. It's great that we're kind of making this a little bit easier and streamlined for folks to do in a scalable way. So I think that's great to hear. Now, Vlad, you came on the show a couple months ago and talked to us about Microsoft Purview DevOps policies, and we'll be sure to link to that in the description. I think Serdan was telling us a little bit about some of the benefits, but are there any other benefits you want to highlight before we get into a scenario and a demo?
Yeah, very briefly to summarize and restate some of the points that Serdan made. One is the central experience, where you can see all the policies that you have created for your enterprise from a single location for SQL data sources in this case, because DevOps policies is around that. The scalability, because we can create policies on entire resource groups and subscriptions that get then enforced to in all data sources that belong to those. We then also have the principle of least privilege that we support, which means that the users that you grant access to will have access just for the stuff that they need to do for their day-to-day responsibilities and not more, especially user data that needs to be protected. And then, you know, the simplicity, because whoever is granting access from Purview doesn't need to understand in depth all the security model from SQL. The roles are pretty simple. The teams at Microsoft have made sure that the security is in place, giving you that guarantee.
Awesome. Great. I'd love to take a look at an example if you guys have one.
Yes, so this is the scenario that we're going to demo. We have a policy that we will create from Microsoft Purview on an entire resource group. In this case, Relic Cloud RG has different types of data sources. Well, we have a SQL Server here that is Arc enabled. Then we have SQL MI and we have Azure SQL DB. We'll create the whole policy on the resource group, but then demonstrate that we give access to Adele, who is a contractor that we have hired to do some performance tuning for SQL MI data sources, right? And for all the different types of, you know, SQL. So, you know, Diego is the policy author. She will give access to Adele. Adele then will demonstrate and execute the queries that she needs. And we will also show that Adele does not have access to the user data. With that, then let me just go to the demo itself. I'm logged in here at Diego. And I have navigated directly to the policy app in the unified portal. So we have here the data policy, we have the DevOps policies. Then Diego is going to create a new policy, and this policy is going to be on an entire resource group, as we said. So he's gonna select that. And then he's going to add Adele. And I'm going to save this policy, which publishes the policy. Okay, completed. Then we're going to go and try to connect now as Adele. So in this case, Adele is connecting to SQL MI. And she's going to try some of the commands that she needs to be able to optimize the performance of the system. For example, looking first at the configuration of the customer environment. Then she's going to take a look at the OS wait stats for performance bottlenecks. She's going to try running queries to identify, you know, running queries, then blocking issues. She's able to do all of that. Like, basically, she has access to the DMVs and DMFs that relate to the SQL performance monitor role. And this includes object metadata and dynamic metadata. She can go and take a look at the tables. So let's have her connect also here on this side so that we can browse down all the different hierarchy of databases and tables. She should be able to see that. So then she's able to see that in this case, this SQL Server has this database. Inside this database, she is able to see, you know, the tables. There is a table with customer information. This is the one. So she's able to see that. Now she tries to do something that she should not be able to do, which is try to see the user data. And in this case, Adele is denied. she does not have that permission, right? She was only hired as a contractor to be able to do performance tuning. So that's basically what Purview policies are able to give you. They're simplifying thing, make it more scalable, but also ensuring that you can have the confidence that users will only be able to do what they're supposed to do and not more.
Nice. I love it. It's super easy to set up and it works, which is a very important part of all of it. So Vlad, I got to ask, since the last time you came on the show or a couple months ago, like what has changed? What's new? What should folks be aware of?
At the point I came to the show, we had launched the GA of the DevOps policies with SQL Server 2022 Arc Enable, which was GA, and Azure SQL DB, which was public preview. Now we have Azure SQL DB also as GA for the integration with the DevOps policies, and we have the integration with SQL MI that you just saw. That's one. Second thing is that we have expanded the definition of the role SQL Performance Monitor, object metadata and dynamic metadata that would relate to the needs of typical customers, right? So you basically can use DevOps policies in a simple way, getting most of the permissions that you would otherwise set up locally. And then the third thing is that we have launched into public preview the API. So customers that would like to interface with the DevOps policies via API directly because they like to script or they prefer service principals instead of users doing this, they can do it now. We have the documents available. The DevOps policies are also billing now. We were in free trial type of period. Now to have the DevOps policies costs about $2 per month. They are charged by policy. The fact that you can create a policy based on the resource group is an advantage because you don't have to be charged for every single data source. You will be charged just for that policy that you created on the resource group or subscription that encapsulates all of these different SQL data sources that may be there and that you have enabled for this purpose. So in a nutshell, those are the differences versus 2-3 months ago.
Awesome. Great. And then I guess my final question is anything that you guys can share with us on what's coming down the road, what's on the roadmap?
Sure. Let me take that one and then Serdan, feel free to pitch in. So first of all, we'll continue to make progress in terms of integrating with different flavors of SQL and moving those integrations to GA. Second, we also have the self-service scenario, which is very important for our customers, and we will keep expanding also into third-party data sources. So basically, policies from Purview will target Microsoft Cloud services, on-prem, like the SQL Server 2022, and then now third-party data sources. In addition, we have another experience called the data owner policies for which we are going to make public the API so that our customers that like to script can interface with that one. That's pretty simple, around only two roles, read and monitor. And then lastly, we have the integration with Fabric.
Yeah, these are very kind of exciting things, especially the APIs. What we heard during this period from our customers that they would like to integrate the policies with the solutions they own, especially in terms of these data policies that could be used by developers. And of course, the thing that makes me especially happy and proud and having the Purview with SQL MI.
Awesome. Great. Well, thanks you guys so much for coming on the show. It seems like a lot of exciting stuff has happened. More exciting stuff is to come. It's super easy to go try this stuff out. So I encourage our users to check the links in the description to learn more and try it out yourselves. Leave us a comment and let us know what you think. Like this episode, and we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.